नमस्कार एवरीबॉडी, टुडे आई हैव कम टू माय गुरु प्रोफेसर कोमलेंदु भट्टाचार्य सर, द रिनाउंड एजुकेशनिस्ट ऑफ नॉट ओनली बराक वैली, नॉट ओनली असम, द एंटायर कंट्री नोज हिम, एंड ही वाज आल्सो द मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट राज्यसभा ड्यूरिंग द पीरियड 1984 टू 1990, एंड ही गाइडेड मी अ लॉट इन माय स्टडीज, स्पेशल इन इंग्लिश एंड इकोनॉमिक्स, एंड इज अ सोर्स ऑफ इंस्पिरेशन नॉट ओनली टू मी but to thousands of students and many other people. I want to ask you, sir, some questions about students' exposure to the modern problems of unemployment in the country, especially in the recent years. So I'll request sir to share something from his point of view of education as well as entrepreneurship and the problem of unemployment in this country during the recent period. Sir, Kamalendu Bhattacharya sir.
Sir, please.
Namaskar. It's my object of pride that my favorite student who lived with us for about 2 years and became a partner in our family, he has by power of persuasion, first I was not so interested to enter such serious subjects, employment. This is a very, it claims our serious attention. Now, when there is unemployment in a country? Very simple question, but if you try to answer, you have to write 100 other things to explain what is unemployment. I will tell you a very simple answer. When jobs are few and job seekers are many, unemployment occurs. You go and ask your other teachers of economics. I am not a teacher of economics. He, in his capacity as professor, Asian professor,
associate professor of accountancy,
associate professor of accountancy
of Guwahati Commerce College.
He has learned economics from me. At that time, I used to teach all subjects. But then I found that this is some wrong path I am following, because you become master of all trade, that means master of none. That is a very famous thing. Now, I will ask the teachers of economics all over our country to make it so simple as that it can enter their heart. When jobs are few, job seekers are many, the problem of unemployment occurs. Now, during these present days, unemployment has reached a tremendous, what should I say, a tremendous nosedive. Wherever you go, in central government, no job. In state government, no job. In private sector, no job. This is the only answer. So automatically such answers will put our boys and young men whose blood are still very strong and hot. So they, when they have not something to do, if he goes to get employment in some concern, be it state, be it government, be it cooperative, he will be interested in that. He will not think of any destructive activity. But when he has no occupation to follow, when he has no, when he has no places to go permanently, morning 10 o'clock office, up to 5:30 office, destination and determination, then return. Everything is chalked out. For those office goers, those job getters, they have settled. But what about the students and youths who have in spite of their best efforts, have never got any job of any category? Forget about the big salary, small salary. These are secondary. First is how he is occupying, how he is spending his time. We always say youth are the future of the nation. But where is their future? Where is their future? Tell me. I do not find any future. Then if you ask somebody, you make Karmashala, whatever in English, Bengali, workshop. You make workshop. learned professors come, they give lecture, these lectures are requested, these lectures are recorded, then what happens? These recorded are sold, these records are given to university for perusal, and they never peruse them. They remain in the dust of the, what is that?
Shelves.
Shelves, dust of the shelves, and the, this what is that, sand level over the record
piles,
become piles and piles, you get it. But I am not of that type, because I am a go-getter type of teacher. I must know what is my aim, I know what is my destination, then I can easily follow it. So, we have to first make our student. As my madam, my wife, Sudeshna Bhattacharya is saying, some minister comes and says, I'll give 5 lakhs of jobs. He will give 5 lakhs of jobs, not to human beings, maybe to SS, maybe to Gandhars, Rhinos, maybe to others. He first says, I'll come and give 5. Day before yesterday, Sushmita and what is his name, Suresh?
Sushmita is there?
Suresh is what about him? Srila Chatterjee.
Huh?
Suresh, what is his name, Suresh? Congress spokesman. Surjewala. Surjewala. They combined together and gave a fire statement. The way if you vote Congress to power, Congress is Mohan Gurbandhan, then we shall give 3 lakhs of jobs. It is on record. It has been reported by many newspapers. But has anybody intelligence enough to ask whom to give, how to give, what is their age group, how they are unemployed, what are the scopes to solve unemployment? There is a bad man. Dekha jayega. They say, come later. This is not the right time to answer. Because they know to keep an issue present, vibrant, live, is their bounden duty as politicians. Because if there is no problem, politicians will become redundant. Nobody will go to them. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir. Of course, sir.
They will never go for any job. So first, we have to judge which section of people, students and youth, which section. Decide, this person is out of 3 lakhs, this will go to SC, this will go to ST, this will go to general people, this will go to special OBC. There are 101. And then, whether we should take people from organized sector, for organized sector, or for
unorganized sector. There should be clear-cut plans.
There are number of such questions. If we want to name all those positions in our strategy, the night will be over. You will miss your train.
Yes, sir.
You will miss your train. You cannot go to ORD.
Yes, sir.
And you will think, I did a mistake by involving my teacher and he has spoiled my journey, then I cannot go this.
No, sir, your words are very inspiring.
I cannot take any train in a week. I have to, if I want, decide to go by train, I shall have to try for the next train. You see, I, with all respect, I brought him for discussion and he has spoiled my journey. Have I?
No, sir, not at all. I've got a lot of time, sir. Please.
Still left?
Yes, sir.
And you will be on time.
Yes.
In time. On time means 5 minutes after. Never do that.
Okay.
You have become sufficiently aged. Maybe you are 50.
Yes, sir.
Very good. So you will always go to station in time.
In time.
On time means you go with a very little caution. Cushion.
Yes,
in
sir.
Chairs we put.
Yes, sir. You always say about cushion.
Say, we keep it there to keep our backbone still.
Yeah.
And backbone is the main man. Main human, in human anatomy, backbone is the most important part. Why? Yes. You see, a man cannot fight, you say he has no backbone.
Spineless?
Spineless, yes, correct. This is also the substitute word, but I was trying to say something different. That's why I say, if he does not sit with this cushion. His back should not touch the back portion, but it should remain very close to it. That is called the posture, exact posture. Scientific and health giving. Yes. Anyway, I am digressing, going from one thing to another.
Come.
Let me very first come to this. When we make a final decision on the category of employment, on the classes of employment, opportunities of employment, then we call for interview. There are many jobs in private sector given without any interview. Come and deliver. Whoever comes, what do you know? Do you know how to write accountancy?
Yes.
I do not know the intricacies of chartered accountant, but I can write what is called book writer.
Yes, sir.
Book writers are many. Tax practitioners are few.
Yes.
And these book writers mislead people, and some people are even penalized by income tax department for their fault.
Yes, sir.
For, I don't say for the debit of the taxpayers, but those persons who practice without any knowledge. And the fault lies not only with that person, but only the person who employs him as accountant. He knows me thoroughly well that he is not an accountant.
Yes.
In our country, pharmacy assistants, sellers, salesmen, they are doctors. How are the doctors? If the doctor is not present, go and report that today I have to go to Guwahati also. I want to see the doctor. What is the problem? Problem is stomach problem. Then he gives a chocolate or something, gives a dose. This is digestive dose.
Yes,
and
sir.
Says if it does not work, you come next week, I will make you. That means half doctor, quarter doctor becomes a doctor.
Yes, sir.
This solves employment, problem of employment. If you check this, then there will be another class of people unemployed.
Yes, sir.
But this paramedicos,
paramedicos
are known as doctors. In village, they are, in town, they are quarter or half doctor.
So they are mendicant quacks? Quacks?
Quacks. There is mendicant.
Yeah.
This word is very rare.
You used to teach us in college.
Mountebank is also saying. Yeah.
Mountebank. Yes, sir.
If you say mountebank, then the listener will think, what is the meaning of mountain here? Mountebank means quacks.
Quacks. Anyway. Sir, one thing. Sir, apart from the promises given by different governments of whatever political parties may be, and the election manifestos, whatever promises they make, whatever party, I'm not speaking for a particular party.
Promises.
Please tell us, sir, what the students should do at this moment, what the learners should do.
Before I go to that, I first warn you against the promise givers.
Yes, sir.
Promises are easy to be given.
Yes, sir.
But very difficult to be kept.
Yes, sir, exactly.
They know it. Those who make promises, they know. This is the thing people will remember. They come and say, sir, there is my problem. Because he knows problem creates problem.
Exactly.
Nothing can be solved in this world. In the world of God, God knows what will happen.
Yeah.
We do not know. We do not have the answer. He will say, and that's why people say, politicians make bridges where there are no rivers.
Exactly.
They will promise anything and everything. And when they come after the elections, are saying, there will be a very simple thing, a mechanical pump for agricultural field. Next, GP got it. So, GP of particular this story, he goes to that person, PO minister, and says, sir, say that all that all. He says, you cannot meet sir now. Why? Because he is in bathroom. For minister,
he is in ministry's bathroom.
Minister, common answer, standard answer. Common and standard answer.
Ready-made answer.
Any people go and approach them, because they have been instructed to say this.
Okay.
Where is your sir? He is in bathroom. Then I say, I have seen your sir in market. He must have gone by the back door. I have not seen. But his direction was to tell that Even if we be there or be not there,
he is in bathroom.
Standard answer is he is in bathroom.
Like parrot, he'll be talking like that.
Yes. So there is a problem. Here, regarding the training of the job seekers. Job seekers will get job easily. Next day will lose it.
Okay.
Some people say, the people who are owners of car, they will like. What will owners of cars do with this serious problem? They say those who can purchase car, their name will be car.
Okay.
And those who cannot purchase car, they will be bekar.
Okay, excellent.
Without a car.
Having car and not having car. Not having car means bekar.
Bekar.
Unemployed.
Having car means car.
Okay.
Affluent man. ये तो ऐसे ही बेकार है, इसको क्या क्या करें,
इसके कार नहीं है,
उसका ऐसे ही बेकार है, मैं क्या करूं, इट्स नॉट माय फॉल्ट यू हैव बीन बेकार. ओके, आई विल ट्राई, आई विल ट्राई सॉल्व. माय लास्ट एंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज टू ट्रेन अप. सपोज ए बैंक हायर्स हिज सर्विस, सपोज ए प्राइवेट सेक्टर पर्सन हायर्स हिज सर्विस, ही गोज जॉइंस हिज ड्यूटी टूडे and hired and fired, next day he is fired because he cannot deliver goods. As simple as that. He cannot deliver goods. So, the problem of unemployment is linked to brain drain.
Brain drain.
Brain drain. Okay. Thousands of Indians get thoroughly trained up, thoroughly educated, and then they leave for US.
Yes.
Then there they do not serve themselves nor their country. They serve what? They serve another country. Who is their owner? Not Tata, not Birla. Their owner is Winchester Company. Their owner is Google.
Yes,
any sir. Company, any and every company. My own son-in-law is a senior vice president of Virtuoso Company, a very renowned company in US.
Okay, sir.
But he cannot invent, scientists do not discover, invent something against the wishes of that company.
Okay.
He helps the company to earn crores. Which company? Foreign company. Which country? Foreign country. For his own country, out of millions, he doesn't get even thousands. His personal salary may be very high. This is personal benefit. What is the benefit of our nation, India? Nobody thinks. Everybody smilingly says, okay, they take pride in that. My two sons are in USA. Third son is going to Germany. Next 3 months after, he is going to Germany. They are all foreign citizens. When will you die? When he will die? What will be his position? Na ghar ka, na ghat ka. He is neither Indian, nor is he any American. He is by certificate is American because he has become an American citizen.
Green card holder?
No, green card holder. Also need not become full citizen, half citizen, quarter citizen.
Sir, in this respect you told me something about South Korea, about the country of South Korea.
Oh, South Korea.
Please tell something, sir.
South Korea, these people are very, very, very patriotic. I say the patriotic number one. If there is a competition of patriotism among the people of the nation, they are the number one.
Okay,
no sir. Country can displace them from that position. Till this world is here. I have seen, they are the second largest producer. This position might have changed. They might have gone to second or third position. When I visited South Korea, they were in first position. What? In steel production, you all know, steel is made up of what? I don't know.
Yes, sir.
And can you believe your ears when I say that though they are the best steel producers in the world, the nature does not favor them even 1 kilo of, I don't know.
Okay.
What a thing, what a tremendous and fabulous and fantastic, everything, fantabulistic. No producer of iron ore, but the best production
of steel
all over the world.
How is it possible, sir?
They purchase all sorts of scrap material from all over the world.
Okay.
Mainly from fish, sheep.
Okay.
Because the sheeps and other steel materials, having such steel materials, so they, whatever they one, if one Korean go to, South Korean go to America, within 1 year you will get them, get 16 of the South Korean.
Okay.
By helping them in their total method, I do not know, this method is a bit complicated.
Okay.
Beyond me to understand, but there is a system. By this, they have imported, exported, not goods, they have exported human brain.
Human brains, okay.
These are the people. Okay. They took to USA and UK, and okay, they earn in dollars, in pounds, and they say this, send this to their own country.
Okay.
This way or that way.
So really, sir, this is very inspiring that very, South Korea told about
very,
South
very
Korea.
Very, inspiring. You say very inspiring, and you say very, yes.
Yeah, we should learn a lot of things from the people of South Korea.
Yes. So this is how, for producing one in those standards, according to SAIL standard information.
Okay. For Steel Authority of India.
Steel Authority of India needed 174 laborers.
Okay.
To produce some machine or something, or steel.
Okay.
174, mind you. The same I have said, 1 kilo, it may be 1 lakh kilo.
Okay.
They require 175 persons.
Okay.
So this is what we may think, that this is top heavy. Some people should be ousted. Some people should be ousted, and there should be a rational distribution. It is not there.
Okay.
In South Korea, you go and ask them, they will say, for production, same, say record, and they are recording same. Production of 100 kilos of, kilo they say, do they say kilo?
Pound?
Pound.
Okay.
Pound they say. They don't say miles. Okay. They don't say kilometers, they say miles.
Okay, sir.
Now, hundreds, what did I say?
100 pounds?
100 pounds. What, producing 100 pounds of steel?
Steel.
They require 15 persons.
Only? And only, where Indian sales request?
175 persons. So how will they survive? Government is giving them extra facilities, extra fund, but they are making state exchequer helpless and hopeless.
Okay.
This is what is going on. We must limit our demand to a certain extent and see what's this, what is happening all over the world. And India is destined to, if India is destined to make a comeback, the committee, this committee is different, COMMITTE. This is COMMITY committee.
Okay.
There is a gathering of all the nations.
Okay.
If the India has to revive its position, revive her position in the committee of the world, India must be sure about this and think about the problem of employment, not only in the present perspective, what will be future, then what will be future.
Yes, sir. Future.
And this then we know as planning. Good planning makes a nation. Good, bad planning unmakes it.
So you have listened, sir says, good planning makes a nation and bad planning unmakes the nation. So this is a very inspiring inspiring speech by Professor Komalendu Bhattacharya, sir. And I'll be making some such more videos with sir, because sir, how can I explain it? This storehouse of knowledge on different subjects of his experience.
Treasure trove.
Sir?
It's called treasure trove.
Treasure trove. Because he has experience in both academics and politics and in different other committees.
I have been able to answer this so thoroughly because I was a director of Steel Authority of India and visited South Korea as a director of steel industry.
So please remember, Professor Komalanu Bhattacharya sir was the director of Steel Authority of India, SAIL, and he has visited different countries, including South Korea, and has a lot of experience on international level.
I'm still the only one member from public side.
Okay, sir, you're still the member?
No, I was.
Oh, sir was only the one member from public side and will be taking...
Private sector. I'm in as individual.
As individual?
I am no industrialist. I'm not even studying steel production.
Okay, see, sir is not an industrialist.
Basically, I am an outsider.
Sir, he says he's an outsider in the sense that...
Outsiders, inside knowledge.
Outsider having inside knowledge because he is not an industrialist, he is an academician, and from academician point of view he has seen what is happening in industries, and he had been the director of Steel Authority of India, and he has visited different countries including South Korea.
I have decided to accept your invitation because I know this will open up channels of debate. And the more you debate, the more we will make ourselves conversant with the problem.
Thank you very much, sir. We'll be asking you several other questions in the next videos. And thank you very much. Thank you, everybody, for watching us. Thank you very much.